Hello and welcome to Learn to Enjoy Colour Mixing with Paul Taggart, Series 1. I really do believe that colour mixing, just like painting, is a life-enhancing process. So many people have told me that once they've understood how to colour mix, they see the world in a different way. Colours in clouds, colours in tree bark, they understand how colour starts to work. And that's really what these next series of videos are all about, how to actually work out colour mixing using the minimum number of colours. In front of me I have several of the tubes of colour which I use, both in acrylics, watercolours and oils. And I've also got my little chart here which shows the primaries and secondary colours. And I would certainly recommend that before you buy your colours, you watch the first video, because you'll start to understand that it's not a specific colour from a particular manufacturer that you need, but what you need to do is understand where a particular colour lies actually on the colour circle. And you may already have several of these colours already. So let's quickly look at the colours that I'm going to use during this next set of videos to show that you don't need to go out and buy an awful lot of tubes, even if you're starting from scratch. So here in front of us we have the red, blue and yellow, which are the primary colours. And for each of these colours you'll find that you need two distinct primaries. Let's start off with the watercolours. And if I bring my watercolour tubes across, we have a red purple and a red orange, and I'll just take a little smidgen out of each of these to show you the nature of the colour. Now each manufacturer you'll find has a slightly different mix for each of these colours, and whoops, there's a little bit of gum in that one, let's just get some pigment out. Those are the colours that I've actually used to create this chart. And you can see in depth they look a little bit different. And this is the important thing, starting to understand exactly where those fit on the colour circle. This is how you're going to master the act of colour mixing. Let's just look at some oil paints now. And if I take my yellows, I'm getting nice and messy doing this. I always enjoy getting paint on my fingers. Here's our yellow-orange. And our yellow-green. So when you're going into the store to buy your paints, you will be starting to look not for a particular colour name, but a type of colour. You'll start to understand the hue of that colour in a particular area. Let's now go for the acrylics. Here's our blue purple. And our blue green. Now you'll even notice that between these different types of paint, the colour varies slightly to the watercolour. And so it's not important to get that correct colour name. The important thing is to understand where a colour is on the colour circle, and then you'll be able to exploit it to its full potential. And you will enjoy the richness and excitement of colour mixing and be able to use it as a tool in your painting. And it will certainly enrich the process of colour mixing, make it a much more exciting prospect for you in the future. And so the colour mixing principles are going to be based on just the six colours that I've talked about. And it's much simpler than you would imagine at first. And we're going to start right at the basics. The first video talks about the primaries, where they sit, and how they mix the secondaries. and what happens during that mixing. Why you'll sometimes get bright colours and sometimes get dull. So some of these strange things that happen when you first start to mix colours will be explained. We'll move on to look at complementary colours, which will extend the range of your colours from six to thousands. And you will start to understand that in nature, complementary colours are everywhere. And that will help you balance your colours right across the picture surface. So it's going to be a journey which I'm sure you will enjoy thoroughly, because it is not complex, it's step by step, and you will soon understand how to really use colour mixing as a tool. You can try before you buy by watching our free to view bonus feature. These Art Bites from Paul contain a little gem from each of the lessons in this series. We look forward to your company. And as always, this comes with best wishes for your painting from Eileen and myself.